I think I've always been creative. I've always liked drawing. I've liked creating things. You know, I've been tattooed now more years than I haven't. I've been tattooing for almost 2 decades. I think it's wonderful that people all over the world can relate to this art form.
I do feel a personal connection to the art that I create. The essence of them is powerful. I want my tattoos to read from across the room. You know, I don't want you to have to get right up on it to know what it is.
やっぱり日本で入れ墨彫ってるとどうしても日本のカルチャーっていうのに興味がどんどんどんどん出てくるんで、それと日本のそういう伝統的な入れ墨のかっこよさっていうのもとか美しさも改めて分かるようになる。それで始めます。
I would say I've had a lifelong obsession with Japanese tattooing. When I was a child, I saw Japanese tattoos in Japanese television programs, and I was just instantly enamored with it. And then from there, devoting my life to the study and the execution of the Japanese tattoo.
One of my mentors who taught me to tattoo did mostly Japanese, and that's my first exposure to the style. I was a professional MMA fighter for 5 years. That work ethic has transferred over into tattooing. I feel like I always should be working harder.
まず最初にお客さんでタトゥーショップ、日本でも当時珍しかったタトゥーショップにお客さんとして彫ってもらって、それで興味を持って彫り師になったっていうのが始まり。
Horitomo is a master tattooist of the Japanese form. I think Horitomo is one of the most amazing tattooers of our generation.
He's incredible. His ability in painting and tattooing and the volume of work, the stuff he's doing is just mind-blowing.
まあ、てっぺんには登ってる気はないんだけど、まあ、僕はいつでも昨日よりよりいいものを作りたいなと思ってるので、その努力はいつでもやりたいなと思ってます。
Japanese tattoos tell all the stories of Japan. You have anything from like tales of historical samurai, folklore, legends, religion. Really, it's just a conduit for Japanese culture.
Every little piece of Japanese tattooing has meaning. You see a samurai looking boy holding a peach, there's a reason. It's not just thrown in there.
日本の入れ墨のモチーフは日本の文化とか伝説とかそういう意味が含まれてます。
One of my favorite stories is Tomomori. He was a warrior who lost a battle on a ship. His entire army was drowned in the battle, and then in defeat, he wrapped himself around an anchor, drowned himself. There's a crab called the Hiki crab, and the crab have a face on it that looks just like a kabuki samurai face. There's a lot of prints from 18th, 19th century of Tomomori wrapped around an anchor withthese crab, and the Japanese people will not eat these crab because they believe they're the spirits of the fallen warriors of Tomomori. That's what's so cool about Japanese is you start to understand the stories, and I try to bring that into my tattooing.
特にアメリカとかでモンモンキャットをやる理由としては、まあ、日本の入れ墨とか文化とかアートのその入り口になってもらえれば、
It's thought tattooing existed as early as 10,000 BC. The first written accounts by the Chinese when they visited Japan, they called it the land of Wa, was that everyone was tattooed on their faces and arms according to rank. The reason there's such a stigma with Japanese tattooing is that at some point in history, the Japanese government has used tattoos to mark criminals. Obviously, this barbaric use of tattooing immediately associated with criminality. There's also speculation that people used larger tattoos to cover those tattoos so they could hide the fact that they'd been arrested before. In Japan today, many people associate Japanese tattooing with the Japanese mafia. A lot of this is reinforced by Japanese cinema.
You know, there's certain places you can't go into. You can't go into a gym if you have tattoos. You can't go into certain bathhouses if you have tattoos. So that's still a real thing.
では悪く見られてますね。いまだに、まあ、特に最近また良くなくなってきて、メディアとかにもほとんど出ない、出せないっていう状況になってます。
The bodysuit is a very striking and I think one of the most recognizable aspects of the Japanese tattoo. Knowing how long that takes, knowing how much dedication, you really respect that person and like what they've committed to and how much pain they've endured. They've certainly earned the tattoo.
The goal of anyone doing Japanese is you want to be doing bodysuits, back pieces. If you can do a whole bodysuit, start to finish, it's really how Japanese tattooing was meant to be, was one client, one tattooer.
I think there's a strong significance and a cultural connection between the usage of colors in Japanese tattoos and Japanese culture, just because you're supposed to be more reserved. In some ways, the Japanese want to keep some things muted and not so obvious and not so in your face.
The palette's pretty simple in Japanese tattooing. You have bold reds, greens, golds, browns. It's not too complex. Heavy and black, the background is the biggest thing that sets it aside.
With an artist like Horitomo, who practices tabori, the hand tattooing, that technique is very important. The way he shades with that, you have a stick and have some needles lashed to it. You use one hand as your fulcrum point to stretch the skin, and then the other hand would push the needle in.
私が入れ墨を彫るときは基本的にアウトライン、筋彫りは機械を使って、背景とか色のときは伝統的な手彫り。
The look you get from tabori, you cannot match it with a machine. It's just much more saturated, the colors are more vibrant, it's not going anywhere.
I grew up looking at Japanese books and you'd see these tattoo parties where they'd have their shirts off and eating food and just enjoying each other's companies and enjoying tattoo art. I started having these ramen tattoo parties. One, I wanted to show my gratitude to clients that had gotten large amounts of work from me, bodysuits, back pieces. These are the people that have allowed me to express myself and have this life. You might joke that maybe hot soup is not the best thing to eat while shirtless, but when you're with a group of people with a lot of tattoos, you all know exactly what each other has been through. And then you can sit there and admire each other's tattoos, and it just shows too how Japanese tattooing just sort of blends seamlessly with life.
As I've evolved over the years, I think my stuff is even scaled back. I'm trying to do less tricks, just make things simple, make things nice and readable, and make them so they're gonna last, make them so they're gonna look great in 50 years.
その、もちろん伝統的な、デザインである程度決まりはあるんですけど、その中でもうちょっと自分がいいなって思うものをちょっと変わっ、ちょっとその、いろいろ考えて作ったものを喜んでくれて、
I think Japanese tattooing has changed very rapidly. A lot more work has been published. A lot of tattooers have traveled. We also see very good Japanese tattooing being done by non-Japanese nationals. What we see now are people of all cultures, of all ethnicities that are devoting their lives to the study of this. There are some people that sort of bemoan the loss of when Japanese tattooing was a little more hidden, was a little harder to get to. But I welcome the information age. That way we can properly document this for history's sake and share it with the next generation.